In this video, I'm going to show you exactly how you can set up HDRI in Vray 5 in the best way. Hello everyone, this is me again with another tutorial, and today we are going to learn how to use Vray HDRI in the best way. I have already divided this process into 5 steps, so that it is easier for you to memorize it and not forget it. And every step has specific settings that we are going to get through. Don't forget to hit that subscribe button and turn on the bell notification so you don't miss any of my upcoming videos. And let's get started. Step 1 is to use Vray dome light. I have already set up this scene and I put camera, so if I press C on keyboard, it will take me immediately to the camera. Right now there is no source of light, so if I hit render, you will see nothing. So the first step is to use Vray dome light. I'll go to top view by pressing T on keyboard, then go to lights. Select Vray light, then change the type light to dome light and put it anywhere inside the viewport, for example here. It doesn't really matter if you put it anywhere. And also, if I go to camera and render it just like this, now there is a source of light. But what I want is the source of light and also the environment and the background. So this is step 1. And step 2, import the HDRI light. After we put the Vray dome light, then we will go to its settings and select on no map. Then the map browser will pop up. Go to maps over here and select Vray maps. Then select Vray bitmap and press OK. This will take you immediately to the computer disk to use your own HDRI. For example, I have this HDRI. I'll just click on it to see the preview of it. Then click on open to select it. Now step 2 is complete. So the step 3 is we are gonna take the HDRI map to the environment to appear in the environment project. So if we go to view and head down to viewport background and select the environment background, we will see nothing actually, because there is nothing in the environment map. So what I'm gonna do is to press 8 on keyboard, then the environment window will pop up. After that, take the HDRI map from the dome light to the environment map and select any instance, so that any adjustment you did it on each of them, the other will be applied the same adjustments at it. You can always switch to gradient color from views, viewport background, gradient color, or select anything you want. So now if I render it just like this, now we have a background, but it looks too dark. So in order to fix this issue, do not ever increase the light intensity from the dome light multiplier, because if you did that, the light will come to the project from everywhere by the same amount, and here where we lose the benefit of the HDRI itself and the realism of it. And that takes me to step number 4, is to put the HDRI map on the material editor to control it. So I'll open the material editor just like this and take the HDRI map and place it on any slot on the material editor, and of course use an instance, so that any adjustment I did here will affect on the environment background. I'll start the interactive render. Then look at the changes when I increase the render multiplier just like this. You see this light effect, the shadow and the light reflect on the building and on the sidewalk. If I increase the light intensity from the dome light multiplier, I will lose this effect. The light control will not just be on the effect. The material editor not just allows me to control the HDRI map light intensity. It also gives me some controls like horizontal rotation, vertical rotation, flip horizontally, flip vertically, and other stuff. So for example, look at the light angle from where it comes. And if I change the value of the horizontal rotation, like this, the whole HDRI map changed its position. That is all for today's video. Don't forget to give it a thumbs up and subscribe for more tutorials. See you next time.